Welcome to PC Tips Pro. This is Shreeja over here and welcome to Python for Beginners. So in the last class we have discussed about some of the basics of the Python like variables, data types and many other things. And we have also classified the programming languages into the middle, lower and upper level languages or higher level languages. So in this class we're gonna go into some deeper to the Python. As we have done some of the code in the last video, we are now going into the demonstration of the code, because practical performance gives you much confidence than being the theoretical one. So I'm going to show you practically how the compiler and the executor works online. So now let's get started without any delay. Now today's topics are demonstration of the code and sequential steps. Demonstration of the code for your better understanding of the Python code, and sequential steps is the extension of your previous topic. So with this demonstration you get a very good experience of the coding in the Python, so that you can try with yourself, as you have already installed the Python and Atom text editors. If you have done any other text editors, it is okay. But if you have to do that, and you can practice over there. If not, if you want to know how to install Python 3 and text editors, go to the previous video and watch it, so that you get a understanding how to install it and how to use it. So let's get started. So the first topic is sequential steps for today. In the sequential steps, now it's the concept of variables only, nothing newer than that. But here I want to tell you, here we got a code over here, we're gonna have this flow chart over here. We need to do this code analysis so that you can understand what is happening in the program, in the code. So firstly, you want to know what is this flow chart. This flowchart is a visual way representation of the code over here. For anything to be known, to be understood carefully and correctly, you need to have some visual representation for the better understanding and faster understanding. So in the case of the programming and code, the execution of the code practically and demonstration, and these flowcharts and tree diagrams will get you a better understanding of what the code is and what the program is. So now in this flowchart and in this code, we just tally with each other, but in the compiler we need to write this kind of code. Not this is only for the understanding purpose. So let's discuss this code by tallying both the flowchart and the code over here. So let's get started with x equals to 2. Here we are declaring that x equals to 2. Declaring x equals to 2 doesn't mean that x is 2. The one point to be very very noted and very very mistaken. So what does it mean? In the mathematics we just say x equal to 2 for saying that x is actually 2. It is a number 2, but here it doesn't mean that. In the memory, x is a space allocation. If you when you just declare a variable x, it means that you are allocating a space in the memory with the name of x. X is a variable, as we have already discussed earlier. And one more thing, point to be noted, keywords cannot be used as variables. And in the future videos we'll be getting a practical note of it, but now just have a note that keywords can never be a variable. So now we are telling that x is equals to 2. X equals to 2 mean that x is assigned with 2. In the coding, equals to symbol indicates assignment. It is assigning something to the variable, and double equal to indicates it is actually equal to. That is our mathematical meaning. So now x equals to 2. X equals to 2 means in the memory a space allocated named x is assigned with a 2. So here also in the flow diagram we have assigned with 2. X equals to 2. Then print x. We know that x is assigned with 2 when you print it x. you get output as 2. Okay, then next, x equals to x plus 2. So when you are given that x equals to x plus 2, that means that you need to assign a value to the x with the value of x plus 2. What we previously know? We previously know that x plus 2 is the value of x. So now we just substitute the value of x over here, that is 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. So now x is assigned with the variable 4. The previously assigned number 2 is wiped off and the 4 is assigned in the place of x. Memory allocation of x will be 4 now. 2 is wiped off. It is cancelled or it is just overwritten with 4. So now if you print x, you know that now x is containing 4. It is a variable. It can change. So x is now containing 4. So the output will be 4. Now in this flow chart, the arrow marks indicate that this is the next step. The next step of x equal to 2 is print x. Next step of print x is x equal to x plus 2. Next step of x equal to x plus 2 is print x. Next, when a program is running, it flows from one step to the next. As programmers, we set up paths for the program to follow. We need to set up the path and sequential steps. What is the sequence it should be and how it should follow the instructions we need to set up, as we are the programmers and we should give the code. So now let's move on to the demonstration of the code that we have already discussed. Now, so now we're gonna see some demonstration. So now I'm using some online compiler so that we get a good experience, because online compiler is better to use, but you can use your built-in command terminal or anything for your device. So it's also okay to use online compiler for you also. So for this you need to just type online compiler. I just prefer to use GDB. So now we here go with the online compiler. You have to use the Python installed in your device and the text editor for the better experience of the Python coding. But now I'm here using the online compiler so that it is very easy to use and compatible. If you want to use the online compiler, it is completely okay. So I personally recommend you onlinegdb.com for the compiling. And now here we have some code over here, just a piece of code, just wipe it off. Now let's select Python 3. Now let's go with the basic program over here. Let's print something. Print single inverted commas, hello world. So let's execute, compile it first. After compiling, if it is okay, then it gets executed automatically. So here you go, you just want to print hello world, you got hello world. Program finished with exit code 0, please enter to exit console. So that's it, you got the print statement. And let's also use input statement, which we have already learned in the previous videos. Input, let's just give a variable. I want to give variable x is equals to input. I want to give input enter your name. I want your name to be entered. First, just go with the single inverted commas. Enter your name. After that, enter your name. You just want to print x. That means if you want to print your name, what is the name of the user. So just see over the code here. See code over here. X equals to input enter your name. Input enter your name ask you a prompt called as enter your name. You just enter some name. That some name is assigned to this x variable in the memory allocation, and if you want to print x, your name will be printed. So just run the code. So it will be asked, yeah, see, enter your name. So I want to enter, my name is Shreja. Enter. See, I got printed my name. That is it. That is it, the code. We need to understand it better to just do many magics. So I hope you like this video and found this useful. Thank you for watching.